Pranita, studying in grade 10, and I take great pleasure to talk about an immense personality. This 7th of November commemorates the birth of a legendary scientist, Marie Curie, a French Polish physicist. She's known to many of us as the first woman to win the Nobel Prize, or the first person to win two Nobel Prizes, and the only person to win in multiple sciences. She's known throughout the world not only for her groundbreaking discoveries, but also for having boldly broken many gender barriers during her lifetime. She was born in 1864 in Warsaw, Poland. Being the youngest of five children, she had three elder sisters and a brother. Her parents, Father Ladislaw and Mother Bronislava, were educators who ensured that their girls were educated as well as their son. Her mother operated at a prestigious Warsaw boarding school for girls, for which she resigned her position after Mary was born. She died of tuberculosis when Mary was just 10 years old. Marie Curie was the first woman to receive a PhD from a French university, as well as the first woman to be employed as a professor in the University of Paris. She also discovered two elements, polonium and radium, with her husband Pierre, and was awarded the Nobel Prize in 1902 in physics. At the beginning of her career, she faced many challenges, such as being rejected from a Polish university as she was a woman. And also, the Nobel Prize in 1902 was originally only going to be awarded to her husband and one of her fellow male scientists. But after protesting this decision, Marie was also given this award. During the World War I, Curie recognized that the wounded soldiers were best served if they were operated as soon as possible. So she developed mobile radiology vehicles and set up France's first military radiology center. She became the director of Red Cross Radiology Center and also helped in the installation of 20 mobile radiology vehicles and 200 radiology centers at field hospital during the first year of war. Also, promptly after the war started, she wanted to donate her Nobel Prize gold medals to the war efforts, but the French National Bank refused to accept them. So she bought some war bonds using her Nobel Prize money. She also spent many years conducting researches for the treatment of the fatal disease cancer. While doing so, the continuous exposure to the radiation caused her own death. She died on 4 July 1934. Marie Curie, the best woman in science of all time, and still today the best known woman scientist. Her research into radiation has paved us the way into radiology, which still saves a lot of lives today. Thank you. Marie Curie, she has certainly inspired me. I hope this great woman inspires you too.
If I never fail, how will I ever learn? These were the great few words told and followed by the phenomenal man. Namaste. I, Aarti Sudhir of Class 9 of Sri Prakash Vidyaniketan, is here to give you some information about the man and his works on the day of his birth. The Raman effect, or the Raman scattering, the scattering of light particles from the molecules of a medium. Well, you might have heard about this theory, right? Then you also must be knowing about the mastermind behind this. Yes, C.V. Raman, an Indian physicist. Chandrasekhara Venkata Raman was born on 7th of November 1888 in the Madras Presidency of British India, which is present-day Tamil Nadu. He was born to a middle-class Hindu Brahmin family. From a young age, he topped in the subject of physics and eventually, as you might have guessed, he contributed his entire life to the field of physics. As he grew up and learned more, he found the potential in himself to do something on his own, or maybe with some help. He came together with one of his students, K.S. Krishnan, and discovered the unknown science behind the scattering of light. Now, light is something that we cannot live without, right? But how many of you ever thought of how it works or what is it made up of? To be frank, I never did. I always took it for granted. But this man spent a precious part of his life in breaking the history of physics. This finding of his brought the 1930 Nobel Prize of Physics into his clutches. People we admire like Vikram Ambala Sarabhai, the space pioneer, was a student of this great man. Unfortunately, on the 21st of November 1970, at the age of 82, he died due to cardiac arrest. He collapsed in his laboratory while on work. But even before he died, he made his students promise that they would not let the field of physics hide in the unknown zone of the world. Let us take his words, his work, and his life as an inspiration, an example for why we want to be the shining stars of tomorrow. Thank you.